I'm Cajon Telza Doc, and this is Telza Doctrine. This is not legal advice. I cannot offer you any kind of legal advice. If you need legal advice, seek yourself a competent counsel, and then please be advised. The information I'm about to give you is strictly that, just for informational, educational, and entertainment purposes of comprehending the Sister K Trust. I hear many people talk about it on YouTube, but I pioneered this. The Sister K Trust is an account that Cajon Telza Doc inherited due to the bankruptcy under FDR, Franklin Delano Roosevelt, in 1933, and subsequent seizing of all gold and silver and other assets as collateral. Now, this account contains millions of dollars and essentially unlimited credit in a name that sounds very similar to Cajon Telza Doc's, a name that sounds very similar to yours, but it's not your name. So the only problem is that the de facto and the legal system failed to inform you and Cajon Telza Doc about this particular account and how to access it. And because they have plausible deniability, they may even deny that it exists. So, in the meantime, they literally have actually appointed a briefcase that I literally joined down on that particular account for their own personal use as a payment to the Pope in the Vatican and the English Crown, of course. So, brothers and sisters, it is the funds contained in this Sister K Trust that the clerk of the court, the county prosecutor, are really after, and not the little hand-to-hand stuff that you have. See, this trust account actually pays all of Cajon Telza Doc's debt, but nobody tells Cajon Telza Doc about this. He had to learn on his own. So the elite considers those assets to be their property, and the Federal Reserve System is responsible for the management of those particular investments. The Social Security, the SSI, the SSD, Medicare, Medicaid, are all financed by this Sister K Trust. That's what they haven't told you, but the good brother Cajon Telza Doc has figured it out. So the de facto makes you pay taxes and a large portion of your wages, supposedly to pay for these particular services that are literally coming out of the Sister K Trust. Why? Which they could actually borrow at any time for any reason, since they cannot access the Sister K Trust to finance their wars or to bail out Wall Street and their Patreon corporations. Now, you may receive a monthly statement from a mortgage company, from a loan company, from an electric company, utility company, or what have you, right? Which usually has actually already been paid by what? They've already been paid by this Sister K Trust. See, almost all of these corporations and businesses, they double dip, and hope that you have actually been conditioned, and you have, because I experience a lot of cognitive dissonance from you guys, you've been conditioned well enough by the credit scams to pay them a second time with Federal Reserve notes, which is really not a payment, but that's another lecture. So if they actually then contact you about payment, what if, in the words of Richard Burch, could it be that if I asked them to send me a true bill instead of a statement or an invoice, I'd gladly pay? Well, not me, obviously. Come on, tell the doc. See, a statement documents what was actually due and paid. Send Cajon Telza Doc that. Whereas a true bill That's what they say. Whereas a true bill represents only what it's due. A statement documents what? What is due and what is paid. But a true bill, again, represents only what is due. Banks, utility companies have direct access into the secure trust. And all they need was your name, your social security number, and your signature. This has actually been a short. I'm Kahan Tata Doc, and this is Right Knowledge for Bill. This is Tata Doc. Take charge of your sophisticated trust by clicking the link below and becoming a C-Code Pure Party Creditor now. Shalom. Okay, though.